Hi guys, so this is my first ever chatty tutorial and I'm planning to do a quick get ready with me for Navaratri function. I'm planning to do a fusion look in the, especially in the outfit, just simple makeup, but it's quite quick in makeup, but so that you can concentrate more in the outfit. And so let's start with a look. And actually I have a quite basic makeup already in my face from the morning, and I have a everyday foundation on my face and a little bit of lips filled up and cheeks filled up with blusher. Blush in the cheeks is already gone, but I have my eyebrows completely filled in. So it's like everyday hack for me to use mascara on my eyebrows and on my eyelashes. So it's still filled in, but we'll start over the look over this itself. I'll start with my foundation first. So for foundation, for my base, I'm going to keep it really simple, and this is one of my favorite Milani foundation stick, and I'm using the shade 215 cream vanilla, and just drawing a few strokes in the center of the face. I like to concentrate the foundation more in the center of the face, and whatever is leftover, I just glide it to the corners. I think it's enough. Actually unboxing my new brush from this is from Sigma. This is F87H Kabuki brush, and this has the triangle shape. Really like the pointy end. I think this will work good with the inner corners under the eyes. So let's start. So this is the reason I love this foundation. It's really gives a natural skin type finish. Done with my base, I'm going to quickly conceal my dark spots and my under eyes. This is my favorite concealer, the LA Pro Conceal HD, the concealer in the shade Peach. It's GC994 whatever, in the shade Peach. I'm not quite comfortable with using the concealer first and then going over with the foundation. For me, and the makeup starts with of course with the primer and then the foundation, so whatever I'm going to conceal comes after the foundation. I really feel that way. I don't use a lot of concealer over the dark spots or under eyes or whatever, and I also don't move around the foundation if I'm going to use the concealer first and then the foundation. So this is how I use, and I don't remember if I mentioned this in any of my earlier videos. I don't like going matching my foundation with the exact shade in the face. I little bit match it with my neck, but I still go two shades lighter than my neck, if you could see, because I like it that way. I don't think I have a small concealer brush. Maybe this could work. I forgot my lip balm. I have very dry lips, so just quickly add in some lip balm. Let it sit there marinating my lips till the end so that I can apply my lipstick. Anyways, I feel comfortable with this brush. I think more than a concealer brush, I'm very much comfortable with this brush to blend in my concealer, and it's done, the base is done. I'm planning to keep my base matte, so I'm not planning to use any highlighters today. What else? I'm not planning to do a deep contour, so I'm not going to use any contouring sticks. I'm just going to finish my base with some compressed powder. This is from Milani, And this is actually a outer foundation actually, and this is in the shade Natural 03 Natural Light. I'm not sure if you could see this. Yeah, from Milani. And I'm using another powdered foundation from Milani. I'm not able to open this. Okay, so this is a little bit deeper shade. This is what I'm going to use to contour, and this is in the shade 10 Dark Deep. I'm going to use this. So first I'm going to set my under eyes and center of the face, especially in the T-zone, with the lighter shade. Using my contour brush from e.l.f. This is a little product so that it is not very deep in contour, and slightly using it here. Have a big nose and a little bit to conceal my this is double chin, my jawbone. I think this step of contouring from back of the neck and dragging it under the jaw bone and contouring even the double chin is very essential. Even if you're not doing any of other contour, I think this step is essential, so that doesn't make your face look slim or something, but I really feel that it gets rid of that double chin, and you kind of look taller if you understand how to put this. I don't know. You have to do it to know it. It makes your neck look longer. I'm going to slightly contour my cheekbones. I'm going to use another brush just to blend the contour line. Very subtle contour which I'm going for, and obviously I'm going to add a blush. The blush palette I'm using is from e.l.f. again. This is that four blush in one set. There are two sets, I believe, lighter shades and darker shades, and these are darker shades because I really like my blush to stand out. So I'm going to use this deep brownish mauve shade. Just a little bit. Smile, and here you go. So as you can see, I already have some of the blush eyeshadow. Actually, I use the same blush as my eyeshadow. So I'm going to literally do the same thing again, just to freshen up the eyeshadow. Putting the same eyeshadow all over my eyelids and a little bit to the crease. Something on the sides as well. So now I'm going to use the same contour powder just to deepen the crease. If you could see the difference, a little bit gives a depth. And I'm not, as I told you earlier, I'm not planning to use any highlighter today. I'm trying to keep everything matte, so I'm going to use my the pressed powder, the light shade pressed powder, as a highlighter under my eyebrows, just a little bit. Just to make my eyebrow stand out. So I'm back. I just filled in my eyebrows with this ultra precise brow pencil from e.l.f. It's in the color deep brown, I believe. Cool brown, where I don't have hairs. this filled in a little bit. And that's it. Today I'm keeping my eyebrows very natural. And so next is eyeliner. And I'm going to find it. Oh, sorry. So very quickly, I'm going to draw in, not so dramatic, but a little bit wing eyeliner. So let's go. Not so dramatic, very small bit. Okay. Now the other eye. I'm using my Milani mascara. I really don't remember the name. I'll put everything. I'll put all the links of the products in the description. So check out for that. I literally forgot to add in some eyeshadow underneath my lower lashes. So I'm going to quickly grab some eyeshadow brush and the same blusher. A little bit on the canvas. So for those who don't know what exactly Navratri function is, I would like to share a few. Navratri function is basically celebrated all throughout India by Hindu culture people, and it is basically we have a lot of gods in Hindu culture, and three gods are considered to be main, top, most, I don't know, whatever to call. So their wives are the three main goddesses which we celebrate. Their names are Saraswati, Lakshmi and Parvati. So these goddesses have come together to win over a demon named Mahishasura, I believe, and they literally win over, obviously. And to celebrate the winning of good over evil is basically what we celebrate these 9 days. So Navratri generally means nine nights. So the three goddesses come together as one body and one soul. On the ninth day is when they get rid of the evil. And so these 9 days are generally when people they pray. They culture has each different things. So it's generally we celebrate all the three goddesses all these 9 nights, especially to bring up their power so that they can win over evil. And disclaimer, I am not talking to about or promoting any culture or something like that. I'm basically a South Indian, but I've grown up even in North India, so I like to embrace both the cultures, any culture, any religion. It's not what I'm talking here about. Just sharing one of my festival in my culture with you guys. Basically, I'm sharing this makeup look. That's it. Okay, so I'm done with my mascara, and I think I can go a little. No, I'll finish with my lipstick actually. And lipstick. Oh yeah. Recently, I just updated my vanity place. So this is the place where I sit and film my makeup tutorials. Is the pathway from the bedroom to the restroom. So it's actually in front of my vanity. So I little bit did some DIY vanity makeover. So I'm getting used of what I have itself set. So I'm literally struggling. Where did I put the lip products? Where did I put the foundations and everything? So I think I'll take a while. And I'm going for a pink shade again. This lipstick, this is a liquid lipstick from Colourpop, and it's in the shade Doozy. Is that the name? I don't even remember. It should be Doozy 20F4. That's what it's given here. So quickly just putting in my lipstick. I'm keeping in my makeup look very subtle, because I'm planning on my outfit and on my ornaments to be a little edgy. It's actually a fusion outfit what I'm planning for. I hope it comes out good because it is not every time it doesn't happen. What you plan doesn't happen properly. So I really keep my fingers crossed for that. So that's why I'm keeping my makeup very simple. So I'm literally not going to do anything more. I'm going to carry out with my outfit. I'm finishing off with my hair, washed and set today morning, so I don't think I need to style it more, and I'm keeping this look very simple, so I'm just leaving my free hair. And here comes the most exciting part of me getting ready. It's my big chunky earrings. I want a little more color, so I'm just putting a little more blusher. So I just chose this statement earrings to go with my outfit, and I chose my makeup look from my earrings. And I want all the attention to go to the earrings and a little bit to the outfit because I put in a lot of effort to create this outfit. So now I'll give a length clip of my outfit. So that's it guys, this is the final look which I came up with. I hope you liked it, I hope you will recreate the same look, and I think the sari drape is really interesting and it's fusion, so any age group people can wear this and feel free to move around in the sari. And make sure you wear the same sari as same color leggings as the sari you're wearing. If it is a sheer sari like the one which I'm wearing, completely sheer. Look how it turned out. It's a very simple and subtle look, and I think all the focus goes to the ornaments and the outfit. Recreate the look, please tag me in Instagram, and if you like the video, of course thumbs up and leave back your comments, and subscribe, don't forget, subscribe if you have not yet done yet, and That's it. Bye, see you.